Hi, ni hao. Welcome to the Do Chinese channel. In today's video, we're going to do an HSK 3 level reading practice. First, let me say, if you're reading at this level, that's a great thing. You should be able to read a few hundred Chinese characters. That means that you can read literally hundreds or thousands of stories in Chinese. But anyway, for today's practice, first, we'll give you a chance to read with no assistance provided. Next, we're going to have a professional audio recording of a native Chinese speaker so that you can read along with them. After that, we'll enable pinyin and translations so that you can catch everything that you might have missed. Let's get started. How'd it go? Hopefully you were able to read many of the characters, but don't worry if you didn't catch everything because now we're going to play it back with the professional audio recording.
Yǒu趣的汉字。小张，你见过木头做的杯子吗？没见过，为什么这么问？我最近学了一个新的汉字，杯。 左边一个木，右边一个布，我以为有木头做的杯子。
木的旁边不是有个布吗？就是告诉你杯子不是木头做的。啊？
跟你开个玩笑，很早很早以前是有用木头做的杯子。哈哈，我发现中国的汉字特别有意思。那当然了。
有很多好玩的汉字，比如娶，上边读娶，意思是拿回来或者带回来，下边是女，娶的发音还是娶，意思就是男人把女人带回家跟他结婚。太有趣了，还有吗？比如嫁，你猜猜什么意思？左边一个女。
是女人的意思，右边一个家，一个女人去了一个家里，是不是女人跟一个男人结婚的意思？读家。你太棒了，就是这个意思，但是应该读嫁。再给我说几个吧。该吃午饭了，咱们先去吃饭，边吃边说。Great.
Reading along with a native speaker, you should have been able to catch all the characters, but maybe there are still some that you don't understand or you weren't quite sure what it was, and so now we're going to enable pinyin along with the English translation.
有趣的汉字。小张，你见过木头做的杯子吗？
没见过，为什么这么问？
我最近学了一个新的汉字。 杯，左边一个木，右边一个布， 我以为有木头做的杯子。
木的旁边不是有个布吗？就是告诉你杯子不是木头做的。
啊？
跟你开个玩笑，很早很早以前是有用木头做的杯子。
哈哈，我发现中国的汉字特别有意思。
那当然了，有很多好玩的汉字，比如曲，上边读曲，意思是拿回来或者带回来，下边是女，曲的发音还是曲，意思就是男人把女人带回家跟她结婚。
太有趣了，还有吗？
比如嫁，你猜猜什么意思？
左边一个女，是女人的意思，右边一个家，一个女人去了一个家里，是不是女人跟一个男人结婚的意思？独家。
你太棒了，就是这个意思，但是应该读嫁。
再给我说几个吧。
该吃午饭了，咱们先去吃饭，边吃边说。
Great job! We hope you enjoyed this HSK 3 level reading practice. As with any stories or lessons that we have, there might be some words that are a lower level and are easy for you, and there might be some mixed in there that are a little bit higher. We try to always keep our lessons and our stories as natural as possible, right? Using natural language, the way that people actually speak Chinese. If you want to practice more, check out some of our other videos, subscribe to this,And also head on over to the App Store where you'll find the Do Chinese app. In the app, you'll be able to follow along with professional audio, toggle the pinyin on and off, and look up translations as needed. We always recommend that you follow a similar method to the one used in this video while trying to first read without assistance and then just use a little bit when you need it. You know, look up words when you have to.Or maybe look at that pinyin when you really have to. But if possible, read as much as you can just looking at the characters. That way you're really going to solidify those characters in your mind as quick as possible. Thank you for watching. 加油! Bye bye!